This episode of Techzilla Bytes is brought to you by the LG G3. Welcome to Techzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Patrick Norton, and you might not have noticed today, given Apple dropped the iPhone 6 and the Apple Watch, that Intel's developer forum is going on. IDF generally is more about developers and manufacturers, but Intel's been dropping new products here for years. So, are you wondering, what's the biggest name in desktop and laptop processors thinking about? Well, for the future, mostly about mobile, wearables, and the Internet of Things. That's their big plans for 2015 in the future. Basically, Intel is desperate to take market share away from ARM. That's the processor you probably have well inside some variation inside pretty much any cell phone you own right now, or tablet for that matter. But first, let's talk about the fifth generation of Core processors, Skylake. That's the follow-up to Broadwell, which you might know as the follow-up to Haswell. We haven't actually seen any Broadwell desktop chips yet, not even demonstrated. Heck, the first Core M chips just shipped last week for tablets, but Intel's already dropping hints about the follow-up architecture. Increased performance, battery life, power efficiency, all on the current 14 nanometer process. It's the talk to Broadwell's tick. Broadwell had some issues kind of coming to life in the 14 nanometer process, so Intel's probably trying to demonstrate just how far ahead of the curve they are now on Skylake. Intel didn't have a lot of details about Skylake. What they did have was a desktop demo, basically a Skylake engineering sample running the 3D Mark graphics benchmark, pretty cool, and a laptop with the Skylake chip inside of it running 4K video. Not bad for a processor that Intel says isn't going to ship until the second half of 2015. That's like a year out, people. Most exciting thing about Skylake, for me at least, is the idea that they're going to have a wireless reference platform, not even a power cord. Actually, there will be a power cord. It'll be attached to a dock, which will do wireless charging to Skylake powered devices. But what's really cool is that everything else is going to be running over Y-Gig wireless tech. Think 3x802.11ac speeds and running everything, your monitor, your wireless, your peripherals. This could be really, really cool if it works and if people actually ship products using it. On the DIY side of things, there was some pretty cool stuff going on with the Edison development platform. Announced back at CES, it's basically Intel's efforts to jumpstart the Internet of Things. They had it running a robot, they had it running some pretty cool rocketry devices, of course, the obligatory fashion. Think about an x86 Linux running postage stamp size PC. It's really, really slick. There's a dual core 500 megahertz Atom CPU, 100 megahertz Quark CPU that works as an embedded microcontroller, a gig of RAM, 802.11a, b, g, and n, including the antennas, Bluetooth 4.0, 4 gigs of storage. It is literally a complete x86 internet connected computer in a little tiny module. Edison modules are expected to sell for around 50 bucks, 60 to 85 bucks in developer kits. It's really, really cool. And we got our hands on a couple now, so you can expect to build soon, well, at least as soon as we can get it up and running on Dytrian. Our sponsor is LG's G3. I wonder if I could use the LG G3 to control an Edison module. That'd be pretty cool. This is the latest phone in LG's award-winning G series. It's got a 5.5-inch quad HD display, 538 pixels per inch. It's gorgeous. It's the world's first smartphone camera with laser autofocus, and a nifty knock code lets you tap a pattern anywhere on the screen to unlock the phone. Thanks to the LG G3 for sponsoring our IDF coverage. Now, I missed the moment when Intel's Kirk Skaugen says, we have to eliminate passwords. You are your password. It's going to be interesting to see over the next year, but I sense there's going to be a lot of biometric evolution in passwords on Intel platforms. I'm also curious to see how Intel's reference design for Android fares. The idea is really, really simple. You build a tablet in Intel's reference design, they'll guarantee Android updates for the next 2 years. That's a big deal for tablet developers. Did I mention Intel really, really, really wants into mobile? We'll see if it works out. You should subscribe at techzilla.com or youtube.com/Techzilla. Leave your comments down below, and we love it when you tweet at Techzilla. I'm Patrick Norton. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Techzilla Bytes. Have a great day.